We have got a lot more very exciting boxing to pack in for you here tonight on ITV. And we're going to show you next a really good battle for the European Flyweight Championship between a very accomplished Italian champion, Luigi Camputaro, and Robbie Regan, the Welshman who really has been the victim of boxing politics. Should have had a world title shot long time ago. Anyway, Camputaro, he started really well. Regan hadn't mixed in this sort of company for a while, and he was really up against it. We're going to join the fight coming up to the sixth round, and Regan is in the yellow and red trunks.
Sixth round. Intriguing little battle this, isn't it, that flyweight's here, Jim. It's good clean punching. I think Regan a little bit surprised by the strength of the Italian at the start, but came well back into it in that round.
Yeah, I think in the early rounds he was standing in front of Camputaro, not doing enough. In my card there, Camputaro went in front after the first few rounds, but that was a better round for Regan, got his punches off a little bit quicker and backed off out of range when he wasn't working. Camputaro trying to get some leverage into the shots now.
He's a bit of an old warrior, isn't he?
Both our styles seem to complement each other. There's never been a clinch.
No, I was just going to say, that's good. The referee hasn't anything to do, really. Just shaking his head, saying, it's OK, get on with that old mate decision. He was looking at Regan and he wanted to say something. They're not saying something, they're a gesture. Now the crowd are getting fancy in their man a little bit more. A little bit worried at the off, I suspect.
In a tough round now, Regan hasn't quite managed to maintain his control. He's achieving a tough, they're still boxing well.
Minute to go in the sixth. Yeah, he fancies it a bit more out, Regan, isn't he? He's got that little out of his system, that opening there.
Nice uppercut there. They both landed good shots, but Regan's was the better one.
Powerful flyweight, the Wilson, isn't he? Good variety of punches.
This is a good battle. Camputaro shaking his head as though he said that didn't hurt. And he's come back with better. Good little fighter, Reg, just as we thought. Good little fighter. One for putting the elbow in. I didn't see that.
Good spot by the Belgian referee, but yeah. Neither did I, actually.
I didn't see it. I don't know if it was intentional or not.
Just a reminder, France and Finland, the judges. Well, they're not getting any trouble now with Regan's cut around. They're just giving it the treatment as always. Have a look at that combination, look.
Yeah, he's getting good punches off now, Regan. Camputaro's still giving him an awful lot of problems, but he's getting his own punches off better now.
At times, flyweight championship of Europe. Third defence by Camputaro, a man from Connecticut. Big been in with some good ones, Jim, the Italian. I thought it had Johnny Tapia, just become champion. And Sugar Baby Rojas, he was a good fighter back in 90 when he was a full bantamweight at 8'7", and he's under 8 stone for this one.
He still looks so fresh. He doesn't look like a fellow approaching the end of his career. He still looks, you know, bubbling, full of life. Yeah, he was just a little bit low that time.
Yeah, but no damage to the undercarriage. Nobody bothered.
Oh, yes.
Take time out, he's saying, while he was talking to him there. Well, that's, you know, what, 4 seconds? It's not worth taking out, is it? He's handling it well, Jim, the Belgian referees. As I said, he's a bit of a student of the game as well, and the Americans are picking him to judge and referee these days.
Yes, I find that some of the European officials get a little bit too involved when they're refereeing, but this fellow's all right. He's staying out of things unless he has to. It's that little right hand, you know, he keeps catching Regan with it. Regan's never found an answer to it.
Good contest though, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a good little battle. Regan usually likes to control the pace in his fights, and he's not been allowed to here. He's having to take big deep breaths here and stay with this little fella.
Sort of atmosphere here, Jim, that used to get with the Water McGowans and the Charlie Magridge and the Di Dowers years ago in Wales.
Well, Camputaro's actually coming back in again. He's boxing the way he was doing in the first couple of rounds here. This little improvement, and he's working this round. Good left hook from Regan.
Finding a smart fight now, Regan. Charting it, it's heaving to the rafters, this place. Just a little smudge of blood again there around the eye.
Just started bleeding again then. Well, Camputaro started this round as though really wanted to take charge again, but Regan really has come back well.
Reasonably level, maybe one round up still with the Italian. As Regan was a little slow starting, threatening to take it over, doesn't quite get control, but's trying to. Could really go to a photo finish.
See, it's unusual for Regan to be forced to work at the other man's pace. He likes to control the pace. He's a very aggressive type of boxer. But he's having to box a slightly different type of fight here. Camputaro always coming forward, always pushing him back.
And he held the championship, of course, during the last fight he had was with Danny Porter, and took care of that. Very convincing, and since then he's had 4 non-titles.
Switched to southpaw just for a second there from the Italian, but then back to orthodox again.
Yeah, he doesn't normally do that, Jim. Still got a good punch rate, doesn't he, the Italian? He lets them go in flurries. Cracking close quarter stuff, isn't it? Oh, he's showing off a bit there, Luigi. So how do you like that?
See, Regan just needs to get his punches off just a split second earlier before Camputaro gets set. He likes to throw them in bunches, so he sets himself first. That's when Regan just wants to get him off a little bit quicker. Very, very close, very tight.
Yeah, it's how this Belgian referee, French and Finnish judges can see this one.
Camputaro has a more kind of professional, composed look about him, good solid little look, but Regan throwing a lot of punches.
Yeah, he's been well handled, well taught, Camputaro. Not that Regan hasn't, but he's a little better than I'd expected, to tell you the truth, Jim Camputaro. And although I'd seen him defeat Mickey Cantwell, he's rising to this one okay.
See, I think Regan's the type of opponent he enjoys facing, a good aggressive man who will stand his ground. You won't like the people who back off. Good round. Close round. Regan in the second half of the fight come back with good stuff. Camputaro very effective in the first half of the round. This is a real hard little battle. Probably harder than Regan imagined.
Corners, 10 seconds. Seconds up, round 9.
Ninth round. Oh, a really cracking championship of flyweights here for the defence here by Luigi Camputaro, the Italian who lives in Connecticut, and the pride of Wales himself, born in Caerphilly, Robbie Regan. Jim, probably still Camputaro maybe edging it, Jim, but you, I mean, you know, we're trying to read the European judges' minds, really.
Yeah, well, I've got just one round up at the moment. But a lot of the rounds are so close, so tight. I just like the compact look about him. Good defensive work. Regan has always been the one who's been pushed and forced into doing things. But it's still very close. I've just got Camputaro 1 point ahead at the moment.
Pace hasn't slackened at all, Jim. They're tremendously fit.
See, Regan's punches are certainly stronger, more powerful shots, but he's never troubled the Italian. The Italian just keeps coming, keeps prodding out of these punches.
So they've got to dig deep now for these closing rounds, the last furlong or two.
Bush from Regan there. Regan's jab is the punch that's really keeping him in this fight.
It's nice and relaxed too. I like that. He used to be tight when he first started. Yeah, there's a cut now around Capitaro's left eye. Minute to go in the ninth. Yeah, well, that's a blow. He's taken a point away there. They've both been guilty of it. Slightly more flagrant, I think, for Robbie Regan's low punches. Give Camputaro his credit, he didn't make any fuss about that at all. Well, that is a definite blow there, Jim.
That is just the last thing he needed. I mean, we had another tough round, another round difficult to score, but that makes it easier for everybody to score. He's lost a round now. I don't know whether I feel the referee was just a little bit cruel. I mean, they've both landed low punches, okay. Regan's have been real low and cleanly delivered, if you like. Maybe just a little bit cruel from the referee. Feel sorry for Robbie Regan there.
Well, I'm disheartened that Regan is not that type of fighter. no knockdowns in this contest. But Robbie Regan just lost a point there for a low blow in the ninth round, which Jim Watt, I think, is just making Camputaro's got the advantage. He started off so well, the champion, in his third defence, third time he's fought in Britain. That was a lot of leather Camputaro did, but he doesn't really stop that many opponents. In fact, the last time he stopped one, Robbie Regan wasn't even a pro fighter.
Now, you can see, I mean, how many times he's landed that overarm right, and he's landed it bang on target, never even troubled Regan. I mean, Regan hardly blinks. He doesn't have a lot of power. It's just the persistency that's given Regan the problems. He never stops. Regan boxing well in this round. Because that point deduction was the last thing that Regan needed.
Almost
a left hook bang in the chin ridge didn't trouble Regan at all.
No, he's almost ignoring the Italian's punches now, and that's a foolish trait, but an admirable one nonetheless, because he knows he's got to really get stuck in now to get that point back if he can. Not a close round, though.
Yeah, I like Regan's punching a little bit better in this round. So far, but it's not over yet. Back comes the Italian. Two proud little battles. Just when one seems to be getting the edge, taking the edge, the other one comes firing back.
That's a rare clinch, that one, isn't it? He's going to fight himself to a standstill. Oh, what a set to now, isn't it? There's some real power getting in there.
He's not a big puncher, Reggio Italian, but he really takes a good shot. Those were good punches coming from Regan. Regan really giving it all he's got here. I think he was worried there that he'd thrown another low blow. I saw the way he backed off, he was worried.
Camputaro gives the impression of the man who thinks he's going to hang on to the title, okay, not worried. Really, the corner men have to earn their form here. They've worked well on that. Jimmy, overhead look. Still Regan stuff this.
That really was a good round. They both landed their best shot, so I think they've both settled down now. This is a distance fight we're looking at. That was a tough, tough round. We'll see who has the strength to come back in the next round.
Exciting European Championship like this. A lot of quality about it. A lot of gameness, a lot of skill.
I thought Regan trimmed it back to a one round deficit again in the last round. But what a battle he's having. The Italian's eye just started
seeping again now.
Regan has never managed to push this man back. Never been able to stop him in his tracks and push him back.
crowd saw that from the back of the hall, but I don't think Camputaro saw that right hand coming over. What a scrap.
There's a little bit of blood in Regan's mouth as well now. Regan really needs now to move into a higher gear. I mean, he's been under so much pressure, been forced to work at such a pace.
Oh,
I don't think he'll have a gear to move into.
Very accurate now, Jim. Now, look at this.
That is where you would expect Regan to have stepped in and followed those two punches up. He really must be feeling the pace here. Those were two lovely punches, but he still had to back off. This is hard.
Sheer grit of it, Jim. I mean, it's something to be proud of with them guys. Like, okay, we know it's their living, it's the hardest game of all. Now, this eye's worsened quite a bit now. I mean, most unlikely, but the doctor may be called. That's unlikely. Yeah, he is too, right at this point. Well, I must say, I hope it isn't stopped with a cut. No, he's let it go on again.
He hasn't even called the doctor.
No.
So for Camputaro, that is good news. If the referee was worried, he would have called the doctor then. But he must have worried Camputaro a little bit. I mean, it's a terrible feeling towards the end of a fight when the referee stops to have a look at your injury. Back he comes again. You think you've heard the bell?
Referee, no, the referee didn't hear it either, and we hardly heard that. The man had been picked up at home a bit with the microphones near the bell. What a round that was. Cracking round for Regan. The referee will let the corner man get on with it before he walks over and has a look at it. He's taken the two round scores from the two judges. And he's going over now, the referee's watched Mr. Ayala. That's the arm you can see of the referee. But no, he's walked away, hasn't called the doctor. With 3 minutes to go, can Robbie Regan pull it off? It's such a close fight. What do you think, Jim?
Yeah, well, I think he's struggling a bit, Reg. I still think Capitano's one round up with one round to go. So a little knockdown, I think, would come in handy for Robbie Regan. But in so many close rounds, Reg, it's impossible to see how the judges have got this. So many rounds that it's been so difficult to split these two.
Barry McGuigan on my right has got an even score. 106 each. I haven't seen a better European title fight in a long time, Jim.
This has been
flyweight.
A cracker. This has been a cracker. There's hardly been a clinch, and they've never stopped working right from the first bell. We've seen a little bit of everything. Quality boxing, real aggressive fighting. Everything. Camputaro, I mean, for a man supposedly coming to the twilight of his career, so much life still in the legs after 11 hard rounds. Regan, I feel, is looking for a big round here. I think he better start going and trying to get that. Regan must be feeling the pace, Reg, because he must know he's the challenger and he must know how close this is. He must know he has to raise the pace, try to take the initiative in the last round.
Punch for punch the whole time. It's not going to be an easy one to call, is it, Jim, when that final bell goes? They'll both raise their hands, I'm sure, to give the impression that they've won it. But
I think you have to ask yourself, has Regan done enough to take this man's title? I just don't think he's done quite enough. He's given it all he's got. But I think, especially in the early rounds, I had the Italian comfortable in front after four rounds, and I think that's possibly where Regan, if he loses it, that's possibly where he lost it. Camputaro got his act together quicker, and he's really kept it on the road. Really kept sharp boxing every round.
like that, with the man backing off like that, falls into the ropes. Oh, what a... We've got to wait for the judges' scorecard here. There's some very wet palms indeed.
This has been
smashing
a
little fight, hasn't it?
A
cracker.
Both have just given everything they've got.
Sucking in air there, Regan. Look at that. Just about nick this final round, Jim. What do you think?
Well, just once again, towards the end of the round, his punching is a little bit better than the Italians, but you have to think about the whole 3 minutes spot.
Hey, well, I think they both do that, because that's how close it is. This is a cliffhanger. I don't think there's any point in the managers lifting him, because the referee has already got the 11 rounds scored by the judges. They're not going to water it there.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a majority decision.
That's how it should be.
The referee, Mr. Van der Weel, scores 114 or 115 in favour of Regan.
1 point up for Regan.
Judge Monsieur Andre the Rock ringside scores 116, 113 in favour of Camputaro.
So one each.
Judge Erika Melanon scores 113 to 115 in favour of the new flyweight champion of Europe, Robbie Regan.
And there it is, the finish, judge. Former boxer of Melanon has made it a two-round victory, so it's a 2-1 verdict by the referee and judges, and Robbie Regan, the Pride of Wales, is European champion once again, and hopefully on his way to a crack at the world title.
Yes, let's hope so, Reg. Afterwards, Robbie Regan promised to do better next time, but deep down, Robbie knows that was a very close fight indeed.